हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू वंस अगेन इन द क्लास ऑफ SY BCom मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट 1। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड लर्न द बेसिक कंसेप्ट इंट्रोडक्शन मीनिंग सिग्निफिकेंस स्कोप एम ऑफ मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजी। वी ऑल्सो लर्न द टाइप्स ऑफ मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजी इन डिटेल। नाउ इन आवर टूडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर कंसेप्ट इन डिटेल। So let's move to the study content first. These are the study content of our today's session. Number 1 is introduction of consumer behavior. Number 2, factors influencing on consumer behavior. And number 3 is buying motives. So let's move on the next slide. This is the basic introduction of consumer behavior. So when we see the basic introduction of consumer behavior, we understand better that consumer behavior can be defined as the behavior that consumers show in searching for, purchasing, using, evaluating and disposing of products and services that they expect will satisfy their needs. Consumer behavior comprises of the actions that consumers take regarding making decisions about buying various goods and services. A study of this fact will often focus on the psychological and other factors that encourage people to either buy a product or reject it for some other alternative. To achieve success in marketing, it is important to understand these factors and utilize these behaviors in a way that encourage consumers to make purchases. Now the definition of consumer behavior is, according to the Engel, Blackwell and Manchild, consumer behavior is the actions and decision processes of people who purchase goods and services for the personal consumption. So let's move on the next slide. Scope of consumer behavior. The study of consumer behavior shows how individual groups and organizations select, buy, use, dispose goods, services, ideas or experiences to satisfy their requirements and wants. The scope of consumer behavior includes the following main content. Number 1, demand forecasting. Marketers can estimate the demand of their products if they know how would a customer behave and react after seeing their products. The concept of demand forecasting is little bit complicated, but in simple word we can say that the demand forecasting means expectation about a future course of market demand for a product. It should be based on previous statistical data and it should be undertaken on 3 levels. First one is micro level, second one is macro level and last one is industrial level. So that we say that is called demand forecasting. Next one is number 2, marketing. Consumer behavior helps to identify the need, expectation and problems of the consumers. Therefore, they can easily build the product having those functions which the consumers exactly want. Number 3 is advertising. Different consumers may have different opinions and reactions on certain form of advertisement. Therefore, marketers can target the consumers with most prominent form of advertisement as per their behavior. Number 4 is human behavior. If marketers are aware about the human behavior of their consumers and which factor influence their behavior, then they can make their product 100% compatible with the requirement of consumers. So let's move on to the next slide. The next important concept is determinants of consumer behavior. That means the factor which can be affecting or influencing on consumer behavior. The following major factors are influencing the consumer behavior. I have to read and explain all these factors one by one. First of all, marketing factors. Each component of the marketing mix, product, pricing, promotion and place has the potential to influence the consumer behavior at various stages, like product. The distinguishness, the uniqueness of the product, the physical appearance and packaging can influence the buying decision of a consumer. Pricing. Pricing strategy influences buying behavior of consumers. Marketers should take into account the price sensitivity of the target customers while fixing the prices of their product. Next one is promotion. The various components of promotion such as advertising, publicity, public relation, personal selling and sales promotion influence buying behavior of consumers. Marketers select the promotion mix after considering the nature of customers. Next one is place. The channel of distribution and the place of distribution affecting buying behavior of customers. Marketers try to choose appropriate channel and distribute the product at the right place. Second one is personal factor. The personal factor of a consumer may influence his buying decision. The personal factor includes age. The age factor largely influencing the buying behavior of the consumer. For example, teenagers may prefer stylish cloth while office executive may prefer formal clothes. Next one is gender. The consumer behavior varies across gender. For example, girls may prefer feminine colors such as a pink, purple, peach, while boys may prefer for blue, black, brown, and so on. Next one is education. Highly educated person may spend on books, personal care, products, and so on, but less educated or less literate person may not spend on such products. Next one is income level. Generally, the consumers with higher income, the consumer with higher income level spend more and vice versa, but this may not be always true, especially in the rural areas. Next one is status in the society. Persons enjoying higher status in the society spend a lot of money on luxury products such as luxury cars, luxury watches, premium brands of clothing, jewelries, perfume, etc. Next factor is psychological factor. Psychological factor influence consumer behavior. These factors includes learning. It refers to changes in individual's behavior that are caused by information and experience. For example, when a consumer purchases a new brand of perfume and is satisfied by its use, then he is more likely to buy the same brand at the next time. Through learning, people obtain beliefs and attitudes which consistently influence the buyer's behavior. Next one is attitude. It is a tendency to react in a certain way to a specific situation or object or idea. Consumers may develop a positive or negative or a neutral attitude towards some product or brands, which in turn would influence his buying behavior. Next one is motives. A purpose is the inner drive that encourages a person to act or behave in a specific way or manner. The marketer must recognize the buying motivations of the target consumers and manipulate them to act positively towards the marketed products. Some of the buying motives includes pride and possession, love and affection, comfort and convenience, etc. Next one is perception. It is the impression which one forms about a specific situation or object. A motivated person is ready to act, but the way in which he acts is affected by his perception of the situation. For example, a student may perceive examinations as an important event, and therefore he would make every possible efforts, including purchase of new stationery like pens, while another student may be casual about the examinations and therefore would not make extra efforts. Now, next one is situational influences. Major situational influences involve the physical surroundings, social surroundings, time, the nature of the task, and monetary moods and conditions. First one, physical surroundings. The physical surroundings at the place of purchase influence the consumer buying behavior. For example, when a consumer is shopping in a store, the features that affect buying behavior would include the location of the store, the interior, the layout of the store, the noise level, the way merchandise is displayed, and so on. Social surroundings. The social surroundings of a condition include the other people with the customer that can influence buying decision at the point of purchase. For example, a bargain hunter shopping with an irritated friend may do quick purchases and may not bargain over the price so as to please the impatient friend. Next one is time factor. Customers may take different decision depending on when they purchase. The hour of the day, the day of the week, or the season of the year. For example, a consumer who has received a paycheck on a particular day may shop more items than at the end of the month when he is in short of funds. Next one is task. A consumer may make a different buying decision based upon the task to be performed by the product. For example, if the product is intended as a gift rather than for a personal use, then the consumer may buy a different brand or product depending upon to whom the gift is given. So let's move on to the next slide. Next factor is a social factor. The social factor like reference group, family, and social and status influence the buying behavior at most. Social factor includes a reference group. A reference group is a small group of people like colleagues at work, club members, friend circle, neighbors, family members, and so on. Reference groups influence its members as follows. They influence members' values and attitudes. They expose members to new behaviors and lifestyles, etc. Next one is family. The family is the main reference group that may influence the behavior of the consumer. Today, children also know about products and services through media, internet, or friend circle, and other sources. So, they considerably influence buying decisions of both FMCG products and durables. Next one is role and status. A person plays some roles in a particular group, such as a family, club, organization, and so on. For example, a person may perform the role of senior executive within the organization, and another person may perform the role of a junior executive. The senior executive may enjoy higher status in the organization as compared to junior executive. People may buy the product that match their roles and status. Particularly in the case of branded clothes, luxury watches, luxury cars, and so on. Next factor is cultural factors. Cultural factors involve race, religion, tradition, caste, moral, values, etc. Culture also includes subcultures and such as a subcaste, religious, language, etc. The cultural factor includes culture. Culture influences consumer behavior on a large scale. Cultural values and components are passed from one generation to another through family, educational institutes, religious bodies, social environment, etc. Cultural diversity affects food habits, clothing, customs, and traditions, etc. For example, Christian ladies mostly prefer jeans frocks, skirts, etc., while Muslim ladies prefer Punjabi suits and burqa. Next one is subculture. Each culture includes smaller subcultures that provides specific identity to its members. Subcultures include subcaste, religious sections, Protestant, Christians, geographic religions, languages like Marathi, Malayalam, Gujarati, etc. The behavior of people from different subcultures is different. Hence, marketer may implement multicultural marketing approach like designing and marketing goods and services that cater to the taste and preferences of consumers from different subcultures. Thus, there are various factors that influence the consumer behavior. Marketers must consider all these factors as the preferences of the consumer differs based on these factors. The next important concept is buying motives. Buying motives are the reasons why the customers purchase the products. Motive is a driving force behind the purchase of goods. Therefore, motives refers to thought, urge, feeling, emotion, and drive, which makes the buyer to react in the form of a decision. There are various buying motives like economic, social, psychological, etc. It is important for companies to know the buying motives of the consumers as it helps them to take proper steps for attracting them and sell the products. The various buying motives includes emotional buying motives. Buying motives based on feelings or passions are known as emotional buying motives. These motives do not depend on judgment, but they depend on emotions. There are some emotional buying motives which are includes. First one is love and affection. It is a significant buying motive which involves the buyers to buy the product. Because of love and affection to the children, parents buy a toys, dress, biscuits, etc. Also, a husband may buy sarees and cosmetics for his wife due to the love and affection. Next one is curiosity. Curiosity is the wish for new experience which stimulates the consumers to purchase the specific products. Thus, to get the new experience, customers may purchase certain products. Next one is fashion. Fashion is significant motive that can change the mind of the customers. Usually customers try to copy movie stars, sportsmen, and athletes. So almost all companies advertise their products by these famous personalities. Next one is pride and prestige. As per the status of customers, he tries to keep his pride and prestige in the society. So customer purchases expensive and luxury items in order to maintain their standard or status. For example, rich customer purchase branded clothes, expensive cars, home theater, etc. to maintain their position in the society. Next one is fear. People are generally scared of losing their health, wealth, and life. Thus, it indicates them to purchase the product like insurance policy, hiring lockers in a banks, and membership of health club, etc. These goods or services help them to avoid their fear. Number two motive is rational buying motives. Rational buying motives are those which are based on sound judgment. They purchase the products through proper testing, comparing and observing the products based on price, quantity, durability, etc. This motive is important to the customers because it helps them to save the unnecessary cost. Rational buying motives includes the following main motives. Number one is economy. This motive indicate that the customer prefer inexpensive and economical products. Customers purchase such product to get more profit and discount. This component attract and motivate the consumers to purchase such product in a large quantities. Next one is utility. Customer wants to purchase the goods which have more or higher utility. Utility satisfies the desire of the customers. Next one is comfort and convenience. Every person wants to live a comfortable and convenient life. Due to this, they get motivated to purchase the products which provide comfort and convenience. Next is customers purchase TV, DVD, motorcycle, washing machine, heater, cooler, sofa set, etc. for their pleasure and comfort. Next one is durability. It is another component of rational buying motive. Because of the durability of products, customers are motivated to buy the products. For example, Toyota car, Pulsar motorcycle, Sony TV, etc. are purchased because of their durability. Next one is security. Security is very important for every person. People are getting insecure day by day due to floods, earthquakes, theft, etc. in the society. So, the customer purchase the key lockers, open the bank accounts and keep security guard, etc. for their security purposes. Next one is patronage buying motives. When the customers purchase the product or services based on a specific place, special discount, present price, decoration, behavior and other facilities, it is known as patronage buying motive. Following are some major buying motives that is comes under the patronage buying motives. First one is service. Service is an important motive which inspire the customers to purchase the product. Customers purchase the product to get the services such as a credit facility, home delivery facility, free installation, free repair and maintenance services. Next one is quality. Because of the quality of the products, customers are motivated to purchase certain products or services. If products guarantee the quality, the customers are even ready to pay the higher price for such product. Next one is location. Location influencing the consumer behavior. Customers prefer to buy those goods which are easily available near their home or locality. Next one is store loyalty. Store loyalty is another important component which plays an important role in buying motive. Customer purchases different goods due to the loyalty of the store, such as attractive appearance, trust in weight, quality price, etc. Next one is friendly behavior. Friendly behavior of salesman also influencing the consumer behavior or consumer buying motives to purchase the product from the same suppliers. Thus, there are various buying motives due to which the consumer purchase various products or services. Companies need to consider all these motives while marketing the products. So student, in today's session, we have to learn the basic concept, meaning definition of consumer behavior, scope of consumer behavior, determinants or factors which can be influencing the consumer behavior, as well as the buying motives of consumer, etc. In our next lecture, I am going to start a new lesson. The title of this lesson is Marketing Planning. Thank you.